The following is a public service announcement brought to you by Peanut Butter.
80% of viruses are spread 65% of the time through 48% of the population in two-thirds of the world forever. The H1N1 virus, or its better-known pseudonym, swine flu, or swine flu in the other country, falls within that first 72% of the 29% tested. When visiting an infected teammate in life, i.e. friend, certain precautionary etiquette should be conformed to. Let's look in on Doug and Tony as they demonstrate the three steps needed to keep oneself H1N1 virus-free.
Number A, the approach. Most left-handed podiatrists agree that the safest way to contact and lure your friend, i.e. the victim, out of their quarantined dwelling place so that vocal interaction can proceed is the pinecone toss. A handshake is always unsanitary. But in the case of the H1N1 swine flu virus, a handshake could prove to be unsanitary. So how can friendly affection still be displayed?
Remember?
Step 2. The heel cup. Place heel in hand.
But be careful.
Whoa, Doug. Don't split your slacks. Let's try that one again.
Befriending. Befriending.
Uh-oh. Tony feels the need to sneeze.
Protocol. Etiquette.
What about Doug?
Adequate.
So follow these steps and be advanced!
If you follow the guidelines outlined in these visually linear headlines, you can feel safe and protected knowing that you will never get the H1N1 virus, guaranteed. Perhaps. Why not? Forever.